Hello! Today I've got another more special effects sort of look for you. As you can hopefully tell, this isn't what I regularly look like. But yeah, this is obviously inspired by winter, at least I hope it's obvious. And yeah, it's sort of supposed to be a snow demon fairy creature. I still am not sure what I'm going to call this, but you know, yeah, you can tell from the title of the video what it ended up being. And yeah, as I said, this is just inspired by winter and snow and ice and cold things. And yeah, I obviously had a lot of fun doing this. Like, I love drawing stuff on my face. And yeah, this actually, by the way, you don't need special face paint for this. I just used eyeshadow, liquid liner, a white eyeshadow base, stuff like that. So yeah, let's get started. I've started out with priming my skin, just my forehead, my cheeks and my nose and my chin. And did I actually mention my chin in the beginning? Point is, I used the baby skin by Maybelline. Then proceeded to almost drop my scar wax. It's the FX wax actually by Kryolan. And yeah, quite frankly, I keep telling myself whenever I block out my eyebrows that I really, really, really need to buy a glue stick to do this. And I keep forgetting. Always, the entire time. But yeah, the thing is, quite frankly, scar wax is seriously actually a good way to block out your eyebrows. From a distance it actually looks quite nice, from up close it looks much less nice. And before concealing it looks like this, obviously, which also isn't very nice. But it's just such a disaster to remove, and yeah. So what I'm trying to say is, I really need to buy a glue stick. That'll probably be much less annoying to remove, like you literally need to rub this off. Like, you can't dissolve it, it just literally needs to be rubbed off. But yeah, first off I started out with a small concealer brush and my Peggy Sage concealer, then I switched to a bigger brush because the small brush was simply taking too much time. Also did my eyelids, so I can immediately go ahead and start priming those while I'm at it. Then I applied powder on top of it, and for this I used my loose powder by Peggy Sage because it also makes a pretty decent primer on top of my primer. I have oily skin and this stuff actually sucks up the oiliness before it reaches the foundation I put over it. At this point I looked creepy. And then I am going to continue making myself look more eyebrowless and creepy with the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation, which I recently bought. I mostly bought it because it has a dropper and I was curious as to what the consistency would be. And yeah, it actually turned out to be really, really, really good. It actually stayed matte on me for quite some time, which is very good, because not a lot of foundations can manage that. Only thing I do need to practice with is the dropper itself. I have a tendency to use too much with the dropper. But yeah, I'll get used to that. My favorite way to apply this, by the way, is with my Beauty Blender, because you do need to be quick with this. When it dries and it sets and it's not going to move anymore, and yeah. It's just much easier to blend when you do it quickly. Then I just decided to go and set my entire face. I didn't bother with concealer underneath my eyes because I didn't feel like it was necessary for this particular look. So for my eye area I used a powder puff and my Peggy Sage powder. And also around my nose and on top of my nose, my most oily areas. Then I stabbed myself in the eye while trying to show you the Catrice Prime and Fine powder. And then proceeded to use that on my face with a powder brush by Sigma. And I'm also just blending out the remnants of the white, well, translucent but white looking Peggy Sage powder around my eyes. Just to make it all look nice and smooth. And at this point you can pretty much see what I mean. Like, you can still see the scar wax, you can still see the, yeah, just the fake shape of my eyebrows underneath the scar wax. It's not perfect, and I actually think people get much better results with a glue stick, so that's really why I really need to buy a glue stick. But yeah, what I'm doing here is contouring. For all the colors, I'm just using my Sleek Eye Divine Ultra Match Palette in Volume 1. Ultra Match Bright. And I'm actually using my contour brush by Real Techniques, which I barely ever use as a contour brush. For some reason, it's just a very convenient brush to powder my eye area with. But yeah, today I'm actually contouring with it. I'm using both of the blue shades from the palette. And just contouring the usual areas. My cheekbones, my nose, my jawline, my forehead. And also my neck. Just to make sure that it also, you know, is a continuation of the face. And that I don't have a weird face. And then just a plain normal human skin neck. And to make my bottom lip look fuller, I'm also applying a little bit of blue underneath there. Then for highlighting I'm using a smaller Real Techniques brush and a white eyeshadow from the palette. If you have darker skin you can also of course use different colors like darker shades of blue. You don't even have to use the same palette, of course, as me. Doesn't actually have a darker shade of blue than the one I use, so, yep. And just a nude shade for the highlights, but seeing as I'm very pale, I can just easily use this palette. And then I had a lot of fun with my Unicorn's Heart highlighter by iHeart Makeup. And just pretty much, spread it all over my face with a stippling brush. It's really not something that I get to do very often because, well, glowy goes oily on me very quickly, but for a look like this, you know, the whole frozen sculpture sort of thing, I really thought it was suitable. And then I just use a smaller brush to highlight my cupid's bow a little bit more and my inner corners of my eyes. Also the bridge of my nose and also my chin and my cheekbones. Because even on top of a highlighter, you know, you still need a highlighter. And then I went to do my, well, sort of eyebrows. The eyebrows and eyeliner are sort of built up from cracks in the statue. Sort of, that's the idea. And I'm just starting to create them using the blue eyeshadow again and a nail art brush. This is the brush that I normally use for my eyebrows. I did obviously wash it after using it because I didn't want to have blue eyebrows all week long. But yeah, I'm just sort of randomly creating the cracks on my face. I'm trying to vaguely make the main line look like sort of a weird eyebrow. And I'm also trying very hard not to make it symmetrical. That's surprisingly difficult. Like, I have a tendency to make things symmetrical, even though I'm not actually all that good at symmetry. But still, it's just, I don't know, it's just difficult to me to do something completely random, but yeah, that's why I really enjoy doing it, because I like challenging myself. And I'm basically doing the same for the eyeliner. I did want a vaguely upward shape in it to really lift the eyes a little, but I again did want it to look random and not symmetrical. What I always learned at makeup school is if you're doing something, you gotta do it well and not do it half or do it sort of. No, like if you want to do something that's not symmetrical, you gotta make it really not symmetrical so people won't be left to wonder if you're actually trying to make it asymmetrical or if you just made a mistake. And the reason, of course, I'm starting this out with the blue eyeshadow instead of the black I'm going to use later is very simply because if I make a mistake at this point, I can still sort of easily erase it with a little bit of makeup remover and a Q-tip. Whereas if I would do it with the eyeliner, that would create a gigantic mess and that just would sort of ruin the entire makeup. And then just blending all those lines out with my pencil brush. This one is by Sigma. And yeah, as you can see, the inner lines, like the original lines, do stay the darker, so they give a very good idea of where the eyeliner needs to go later. However, it does blend it out enough that it sort of forms sort of a frozen area almost around the cracks. At least it will look like that in the end. Then I also did some more blue around my mouth and my nose with a fluffy blender by Sigma. And then also filled in my crease with this because I felt my eyelids were a little bit too bare. I don't know, the blue was there and then it just randomly stops when it hits the crease and it just didn't look right to me. So I decided to fill in the crease a little bit as well. Try not to blend it too high though, because if you're hitting the scar wax then it won't blend nicely. I discovered that here, yeah. And then I grabbed a liquid liner. This one is by Maybelline, it's the Line Refine. At least I think it was Maybelline. Whatever it was, I'll put it down below in the description box as always. Like all the color codes and, you know, anything. Like the full names of the products will be in the description box as usual. And yeah, then I'm just very carefully tracing the original lines of the blue. And obviously I did cut a lot because otherwise the footage of me applying the black liner would be half an hour long on its own. And yeah, you know, all really I can tell you about this, like all advice I can give you, is really, really take your time. Don't rush yourself. And also grab an eyeliner you really have faith in. Like an eyeliner you're comfortable with. Not one that's too dry that you need to like rub over it 12 times. But also not one that's too runny. This one is actually perfect for this sort of thing, in my opinion. Because on one hand it is... Well, I did need to dip quite a few times to get enough color payoff. However, it didn't drip. Like, I'd rather need to apply a line a few times rather than to apply it once and then have like a gigantic smudge of black eyeliner on my face, because that's just, you know, as they always say, it's much easier to add something than to remove something again. and also this one is a very nice tiny brush. However, again, this is all up to personal preference. I know a lot of people actually prefer felt tips. Me personally, I don't really like them, but for a lot of people they're a lot more comfortable, so just use whatever you're the most comfortable with. And then I actually did a step that was completely redundant in the end, but I wanted to show it to you anyways, because I don't know, here's proof that I don't always know what I'm doing. I just applied a color tattoo, a silver color tattoo in my waterline with a synthetic brush that I bought ages ago at Body Shop, I think. And then for my eyelashes, I used a spoolie by Peggy Sage and a Bed to the Bone, a Lit Lingerie by NYX, which is actually sort of an eye primer-esque thing. But it also makes a very decent mascara, as you can see. With this sort of look, like the whole frosty look, I always like having white eyelashes. And then I decided my face still looked too bare. Believe it or not, with looks like these, I have a plan in mind, but I also sort of, just right at the moment when I'm doing it, I just look in the mirror and I just, you know, add something or take stuff away, you know, just by how it looks at that point. Because sometimes you have an idea and then you put it on your own face and it just doesn't look the same as you had in mind. At least it happens to me a lot. And yeah, originally I only wanted to do the black cracks to form the eyeliner and eyebrows with, but it just looked too bare, so I decided to add some highlights as well. With Bed to the Bone and the same angled brush, the nail art brush that I used for the original blue lines. And I sort of just applied these as a highlighter of sorts. So on the bridge of my nose, on my forehead and also on my cheekbones, and I also added them on my chin. And again, I just really took my time with this. Alternatively, if you're not comfortable using a cream product immediately, you could of course just start with white eyeshadow. But quite frankly, that probably wouldn't have been visible on my face. But yeah, it's an option. But I just tried to be very careful with this. And you know, white is on pale skin still easier to remove than black, so that helps. And again, I just tried my best to do it as asymmetrical as possible. Just making sure it all looks complete, yet not, you know, too neat. Then I decided I wanted my eyes to be darker anyways. Which, yeah, that's what made the step with the color tattoo completely redundant, because I then put a black eye pencil on top of it. This one is by Estee Lauder, it's Black and Black. And I use it every single time I use a black eye pencil, so I am actually planning on buying more eye pencils, so I might actually show you some different brands in the future. But obviously I need to try them out myself first, and by that time the Bed to the Bone had dried up. So I could apply glitter on top of it. I used the Glitter Glue by NYX. Glitter Glue is called Glitter Primer. Yeah, I always call it Glitter Glue for some reason. But yeah, I just roughly apply that on the white lines and then roughly dab glitter on top of it. I didn't want them to be all glittery, I just wanted them to have a slight sparkle, as if they're sort of like frozen spots on the skin. Frozen in a pretty way, not in a actually frostbitten way, obviously. The glitter I'm using is actually one that came from a gardening store. It's more of a decorative kind of glitter than a cosmetics glitter. I'm not using it on my eyes, so I feel like this is safe enough. However, it's all up to you what you want to use on your face. Of course, cosmetics glitter is actually meant to be used on the skin, whereas the glitter I'm using isn't, so cosmetic glitter is always the safest way to go. And then for my lips, I use a blue lipstick. I got this off of a pretty store, I think, well, I'm sure it's a few years ago, I just have no idea how many years exactly. It was only 99 cents, it's really cheap, and it doesn't have a brand name on it, it doesn't have any sort of name on it. Like, it's literally just a black tube with a blue lipstick, but it is very nice and creamy. And quite a lot of brands, I think NYX, at least in the budget, more budget-ish brand division, actually have a black lip, or a blue lipstick as well. And probably also a black one, but the black one I'm using is by Essence, also a couple of years old. And I'm pretty much just applying the black in the inside of the mouth and then just blending the two together. To sort of create a look that matches the eyes and the cracks. And then here is the final result. So I think more of a, like, I didn't want it to be necessarily creepy, but I wanted it to be slightly creepy. More of a character-ish look than actually a, you know, horror look. But yeah, I did eventually actually really like how it turned out, and I'm also surprised at how well the dry shampoo actually worked to make my hair look white. I actually stayed looking like this for about half an hour, in case you wanted to know. So here's the final result. Yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video, and yeah, I hope I inspired some people to also paint icicles on their face. For now, at any rate, thank you very much for watching. If you did like this video, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you'd like, you can also subscribe to my channel. For now, again, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!